Now, after the long weekend, you may have returned to work thinking every week should be a four-day week.
I actually did. We know some countries are already embracing shorter work weeks, but one accounting firm in Te Puke has an alternative, the six-hour workday. Ben Hurley has more.
The six-hour workday sounds like the sort of crazy idea a Silicon Valley company would come up with, along with hammocks in the boardroom, infinite sick days, and bring your dog to work days. But a rural accountancy firm in the Bay of Plenty town of Te Puke is employing the six-hour day full-time.
A couple of years ago, we were thinking about how we could do things a bit differently. Main reason was really to try and attract talent, to attract people to the area. So we thought, right, let's just have a wee think about this. We read a book called The 5-Hour Workday, and we thought, oh, could this work for us?
In our line of work, you're working with technology all day. By the time you've done 6 hours, your brain's pretty fried. So, you know, in the old days, you'd probably just been, you know, padding your time to get to that 8 hours.
So basically, you end up with an hour and a half a day to go and do whatever you like with it.
Basically give the ultimate gifted time back to our people, our team.
There we had to think about how people work, because we've still got the same amount of work to do in a year, but we need to try and cut back on things that don't actually add value to what we do, or to find more efficient ways of doing things.
Most of our clients' feedback is, oh God, I wish we could do the same thing. So yeah, I think it's good. I love what we do.
When I first started here, I was doing renovations to an apartment, and that extra 2 hours when I could go and meet contractors on site, and something that's normally really stressful was, you know, like way less stressful because of what we get offered here.
Yeah, I've been here 15 years and it's so much better. Obviously, stopping at 3 o'clock.
What did you get player of the day for, or is it secret?
I helped Martin apply for his passport.
You helped one of the partners apply for his passport. That's all it takes.
Yeah.
If I had 2 hours a day, this is what I'd get good at.
Well, I've noticed I've got more energy, time to myself. That's the big one. As I say, for me, I can play sport in the weekends, and now I can go train after work and everything while it's still light.
Here's how much GST you'll pay. Ooh, 18%.
2 extra hours a day sounds amazing, but what would the people of Te Puke do with that extra time?
Jump on my bike, go for a bit of a ride, go and shoot a few rabbits.
Fishing down on the Pickaway Strait.
I'll go to my friend's house and then he's going to cut my hair for free.
It's working, man, you've got a great lid.
All great ideas, but with all that improved mental health from working less, what about taking up the relaxing sport of golf?
Going back to work.
You know, I'm just thinking about your day, your 6 hour day, you know, when you're in here.
Sorry, 8 hour day.
9 hour day, 10 hour day, but most of it's spent either drinking tea with other people or gas bagging or sometimes cooking, baking for people and eating that baking.
That's quite harsh to say gas bagging. Talking to people is all part of creating a culture at work. That's simply what I'm doing. I'm just helping to create a vibe and a culture.
At work.
And that's at work.
Well, what about the long lunches?
We're allowed a lunchtime.
Comes back very chatty from the long, very chatty after the long lunches.
Slightly chattier. Yeah. But no, I'm just creating a vibe.